Thank you very much, Evan and Lana, of course, for the support and collaboration. First of all, I would like to thank you, the CHS and Aristotle University of Thessaloniki, for this fellowship. It's a great honor for me to participate in this research program. Also, I'm so grateful to my supervisors, Mrs. Evanthia Sistakou and Anastasia Rasmia Peponi, for useful observations and corrections, of course. It's an amazing experience, and which I will keep in my heart and my mind for many years. I'm so grateful. Today, we will talk about ancient medicine, and especially the role played by women in medicine, and the research focuses on epigraphic materials. From the archaic period to the late antiquity, engaging in medicine was a privileged area only for a man who practiced the occupation either publicly and privately, holding the position as a public doctor and chief doctor, in Greek archiatros. On the other hand, women were restricted to midwifery and referred to as midwives, in Greek mes. There are rare cases where women were called doctor, iatros, or physician women, iatrini, and may have been permitted the same professional rights as their male counterparts, as well as the same scientific education. The fact that women were excluded from medicine during antiquity is evidenced by the absence of both literary sources and inscriptions. The present study mainly focuses on four issues. The first, to present the epigraphic sources referring to female doctors and midwives. The second, to identify the social level of these women. The third issue is to examine the ways in which women have acquired medical and obstetric knowledge. And the last one, to clarify the ways in which medical or obstetric status is declared. A total of 28 inscriptions of women are examined. They are categorized into three different categories according to the way in which medical and obstetric statuses are declared. Sometimes women are called physician women, in Greek, iatrini, with different dialectical variants, sometimes called midwives, mes, and sometimes bearing the compound title of midwife physician, iatromes, or doctor and midwife at the same time. The inscriptions cover a long period from the 4th century BCE to the 6th century CE, and a wide geographical range of the ancient world, including Attica, Macedonia, Byzantium, Thrace, the Aegean Islands, Asia Minor, Rome, and Spain. Let's start from the first category about physician women, iatrines. The term physician women, iatrini, is the feminine form of the word doctor, iatros, and means the one who heals. The word iatros, doctor, appears for the first time in Homer in a response of Patroclus to Achilles, who reminds his son of Peleus that doctors are trying to heal the cured heroes of Achaeans. In Plato, the term iatros, doctor, is used to denote the specialist in medicine. The term in the female form often appears in inscriptions without precisely indicating the female doctor, but usually implies the midwife or woman with medical skills corresponding to the fields of gynecology and obstetrics. In addition, the term describes women who care for children. Xenophon states that the role of the caregiver woman was the responsibility for caring for her husband's slaves without any discriminations of gender. So it was not uncommon for women to heal minor injuries or other illnesses found in women in need, slaves, or children. Undoubtedly, some women cared for men, although social stereotyped perceptions discouraged or even banned such services. 13 inscriptions can be classified in this category of physician woman. Most of the inscriptions, 8, refer to woman doctors with the term iatrini. In 4 inscriptions, medical status is not explicitly stated in an appropriate term, but rather implying woman's medical skills and knowledge. There was even a case where the term chief doctor, archaiatrini, occurs. The earliest of these inscriptions were found in the area of Thrace and is engraved on funerary stele. It is a simple statement which informs us that Musa, Agathocles' daughter, was a physician woman without giving more details on the content of her profession. At the same time, the name of the dead woman refers to the mythical traditions of the Muses, possibly implying the Musa Meleti. Trevulia is also described as iatrini in a funerary stele from Ankara, Turkey. Trevulia, named Hapax Legomenon on inscriptions, may have specialized in gynecology and obstetrics, as no information is available on specific medical knowledge or duties. With the word phronousa, the first line, her spiritual superiority and intellectual virtues are prized. In an inscription from Bithynia, Gaius Julius Vettianus dedicated the funeral monument to his wife Pieria. The term iatrini, with this particular phonological variant, appears in another inscription from Attica as the definitive adjective of the goddess Rhea. The name indicates knowledge, experience, and practice, and is probably related to the knowledge and experience of women in medicine. The word Pieria is found in the context of medical inscriptions and in Plato's law with medical arguments. Attalis is also described as physician woman in a tombstone inscriptions from Pisidia of Asia Minor, but her medical skills are not clearly stated. It is a parental dedication to the daughter of Diochis. During the Christian period, the statement of medical status is still being made comprehensively, as evidenced by the cases of Amazona from Byzantine, which is why she was liked by both God and man. Amazona is inscribed as the first Christian woman to be called Iatrina. The name refers to the mythical Amazons and is repeated twice, line 2 and line 3, for emphatic reasons. It may depict the virginity of the woman, which reinforces the assumptions that she was Christian, faithful servant of God, in Greece, pisti douli to Theou, and may have had monastic influence. Thecla is characterized as iatrini in an inscription from Selefkia, while the presence of the cross signifies her Christian identity. The name is particularly associated with Selefkia, as according to Christian tradition, Hagia Thecla was the patron saint of the region. In the same meaningful context, there are recent inscriptions from Corinth, from Caria, inscribed in sarcophagus. The restorations of the name remains uncertain, but the term Iatrinis proves that it is a woman's grave. The funerary inscriptions from Athens is dedicated to the female physician Susanna. The name is related to the verb save, in Greek sozo, through the prefix sos, referring indirectly to the woman's ability to save, cure the sick of diseases. The expressions close to angels, plesion ton agelon, in line 2, underlines the eschatological Christian conception for the afterlife. In other cases, the declarations of woman's medical status is achieved through metaphorical statements that reveal their knowledge and practice of medicine. In an inscription from To of Lycia, the citizens honor Antiochus with erections of statue, as Antiochus assisted the city with her medical knowledge and experience. Antiochus of inscriptions is not literally unknown, as Galen mentions here as the creator of drug for spleen pains, septicemia, and rheumatism. If her father, Diodotus, associated with the person mentioned by Dioscurides, then her professions probably run in the family. An indictions of the family tradition of the profession is also present on the inscriptions of Panthea from Pergamon. Panthea, although a woman, served her medical art, which she was taught by her husband, and did not fall short of any abilities and skills, as is referred in the expression «Κεκλέος υψώσας ξινώνει ιτορίας, ουδέ γινή περαιούσα εμείς απολύπαιο τέχνης». «Raised height our common fame in healing, though you were a woman, you were not behind me in skill». The epigraphy is a prize from her husband Glycon, who was a doctor himself. At the same time, the memory of her father, Philadelphus, who noted as a doctor, highlights that the medical profession was a family tradition. The declaration of the medical status of Domnina is implied in verse 4, Patrin riomenin nuson arpasan, none of mortals will say that you died, but that the immortals stole you away because you saved your native fatherland, suggesting that Domnina probably had more general medical knowledge. Helped and relieved the city of ill health using her art. The word eteris in line 4 may imply her male colleagues, including her husband, to whom her death had caused sadness and lament. In another inscription from Pisidia of Asia Minor, Alexandria Zosimi's professional status is stated by the expressions from medical science, apo epistemis iatricis. The funerary stele was erected by her husband Asclepiades, who may have been a physician himself. Zosimi may have had broader medical knowledge. The special case of Augusta from Lycaonia concludes the category of physician women. The term archiatrina, chief physicians, appears once, and it is noted that the Augusta had relieved many of the sufferers from the pain, brought healing to the bodies of many sick people. It is folon somasi aroston iasin dedoke, line 6 to 10. Due to the fact that her husband was a chief doctor, archiatros, it can be deduced that Augusta was a prominent figure of the local community. The couple may have worked together, and the woman's medical qualifications were equal to her husband's, so that she would not be considered as an assistant or inferior. Let's see the second category about midwives. According to mythology, the goddess Athena was the first midwife to assist Leto in giving birth, and later taught her art to goddess Artemis. In ancient Greece, the first midwife was Agnodike, who disguised herself as a man in order to taught the obstetrics by Herophilus. Plato mentions that the mother of Socrates, Phinarete, who was a midwife. At the same time, he presents the ideal persons to be a midwife as an older woman that is over childbearing age, not being infertile, and she must have already experienced motherhood. Moreover, she has to use several medicines to deliver a birth with less pain, to be able to help those women who cannot bear a child, and also to know the process of procuring abortions if necessary. In Rome, the information of the professions of midwife comes from the work of Soranus of Ephesus. He presents the characteristics as the ideal midwife, pointing out that she must be sober, discreet, non-discriminatory, hardworking, and have training in diet, surgery, and pharmacology. The majority of inscriptions referring to midwives are mere declarations of obstetrical status. The earliest inscriptions come from Halkeida, Euboea, and informs us about the obstetrical capacity of Aristocleia. In a fragmentary inscriptions from Hispania, the term mea, midwife, is presented in the second verse, which is preserved intact. This proves that the inscriptions refers to a woman who was midwife. As midwives, mes, without further declaration, are characterized elpis in an extensive degree of gut mandros from Chaim, Euboea, Ephrosini and Parias from Paros, Heklia from Miletos, Aristra from Miletos, the anonymous women, Sarapias from Athens, Sarapias Mea Christi Here, Saturnila from Aegina, and finally, Myrini from Asia Minor. Finally, in the epigram from Rome, Julia Primigenia is described as a midwife whom, having saved many women with her obstetric skills, but failed to escape her own fate. The third category is midwife physicians. The list of female midwife physicians is completed in three separate cases that draw attention to the dual status of physician and midwifery capacities at the same time. The earliest inscriptions derives from Athens and dates to the 4th century CE. Phanostrati has the dual status of midwife and doctor, which leads to the connections of her two professional capacities. On the one hand, the word mea implies that this may have been her primary capacity. The characterizations regarding to the male gender as a doctor, iatros, is a noticeable difference for the majority of female physicians who are identified as doctors of the female gender, iatrini. On the other hand, perhaps not only was she a wise woman, but she also had more general medical knowledge and could be possibly cure various diseases. Similar content is expressed in another inscriptions from the region of Dion in Macedonia in the 2nd century CE. The funeral altar was commissioned by Ulpius Zosas in order to honor the memory of his wife Julia Eftichiani, who was a doctor and midwife. This dual distinctive feature makes the case of Eftichiani unique in Dion and in Macedonia. Eftichiani is initially called a doctor, noting her capacity as a therapist. The expression mea thiliteron, midwife of young women, literally states that Eftichiani was fully responsible for taking care of the young pregnant women, thiliteron, who assists them in pregnancy and also in childbirth. Eftichiani is described as a doctor of men, Androni Itir. This is quite rare, as it was difficult for a woman in antiquity to acquire general medical knowledge and to cure various diseases, except in rare cases where apprenticeships with a male doctor were possible. The word Andron precedes and emphasizes Eftichiani's ability to visit or receive male patients at home, providing medical services, while at the same time giving a distinctive tone to her other status as a midwife. Unlike the word thiliteron following the status of a mea, the word andron may imply that this was her primary professional status. The last inscription is from Corikos in Asia Minor and is Christian, as evidenced by the presence of the cross at the beginning of the text. It is dedicated to Georgios, the son of Stephanus and Stephanis, who was a midwife physician, iatromeas. The term iatromea is compound word formed by the prefix iatros and word mea, and denotes that the woman who was a midwife, but also had medical knowledge and skills. The above overview of the epigraphic evidence has highlighted some crucial points about the role and positions of female doctors in the ancient world. In particular, the role of the physician was not specifically defined from that of the midwife, making any assumptions about the nature of and responsibility of its property obscure. The absence of epigraphic testimonies for female physicians and midwives during the classical period may also indicate the suspicious or negative attitude of societies towards female therapists. This attitude is also evidenced in the literature and medical text of the period, as the term iatros, physician, does not refer to women, while the term mea does not fully reflect the status it has had since the Hellenistic period. Midwives began to appear in inscriptions during the 3rd century BCE. These inscriptions recognize the value of women in obstetrics. In the years that followed, until the Roman period, inscriptions referring to female physicians and midwives were increasing. Most of these inscriptions are simply statements of midwifery or medical status, while some other inscriptions mention the name of the deceased, the patronymic or husband name, and the usual farewell to the deceased at the end of the text. During the Hellenistic period, there are several examples that demonstrate the recognitions and acceptance of local communities towards female physicians and midwives. In the case of Adiochis from Tlo, the city council recognizes the value of the deceased woman and honors her by erecting a statue in the center of the city. Panthea from Pergamon is prized in the funerary epigram for her reputation as a valued member of the local community of Pergamon. Furthermore, as a therapist is considered as an equal to her husband. Finally, the recognition of the city towards the deceased female doctors and midwives is also evident in the case of Domnina, who saved the city from diseases. However, in addition to the simple and comprehensive inscriptions, more complex inscriptions appeared during the Roman period, in which medical or obstetrician status is sometimes attributed to in a literary way, thereby giving added value to the status of deceased woman. The special literary ways indicate the social status of honored women, as well as their education and training. During this period and onwards, there are also cases where women are minor or secondary characters and are not the most highly honored individuals in the inscriptions. Indicative examples are the cases of Stephanis, who is identified as a midwife physician and honors her son, Saturnilla, who set up a tombstone in order to honor her husband, and Attalis, who along with her husband set up the monument in order to honor her daughter Adiochis. During the Roman period, the Romans showed their preference for Greek female physicians and midwives, recognizing their medical capabilities. This evidence by the Greek inscriptions of Pieria, which is dedicated to her by her Roman husband, Gaius Julius Vettianos. The use of the Greek language in inscriptions indicates the couple's Greek education. An indication of the honor of the Romans to the Greek female physician is the inscription of Zosimi, which is in a public statue indicating that the deceased was publicly honored. During the Christian period, inscriptions are defined on the one hand by their literary content, on the other one by the use of special symbols, such as the cross. These inscriptions have sometimes an eschatological notions that their gods, their good deeds are rewarded in the afterlife, whereas in the other cases, these are mere declarations of medical or obstetric status, such as the cases of Thecla and Stephanis. These inscriptions have a simple form indicating the name of the deceased and the little or occupations and the title of occupations. The designations of midwife and female doctor iatrini are not free of their metaphorical clue implying healing from sins. The majority of the inscriptions come from the regions of Asia Minor and dates back to the Roman period. This fact is related to the establishment of female doctors and midwives through the writings of contemporary authors such as Soranus and Pliny, who present the female physicians and midwives as reliable sources of healing. On the contrary, the epigraphic testimonies of female physicians from Athens prove that women were accepted, but they did not have the same social status and wealth as their counterparts from the regions of Asia Minor. From the above presentations of inscriptions, the context of education and training of female physicians and midwives is not revealed, as no further information is provided in the texts. The only two exceptions are the inscriptions of Augusta, who may have been trained and worked with her husband, who was a chief physician, as well as the case of Aurelia Alexandria Zosimis, whose husband and father were doctors and was possibly trained by them. The examinations of Greek inscriptions on female physicians, midwives, and midwife physicians is not only the single contributions of women to ancient medicine. The research could also be extended to individual medically related specialities such as pharmacology and herbal medicine, where the contribution of women is significant. In addition, the present research would be more abundant if enriched with material from other primary sources of research, such as archaeological and papyrological findings, whose examinations could complete the mosaic of women's medicine in antiquity. Thank you very much for your attention.